Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we are back for another trailer react. It's the Gaming Squad because it's a game we got. I'm Kuya P. I got Brian Saf. I got Webster Style. It's NBA 2K23. Y'all ready to hoop it up with the legend from the Chicago Bulls, MJ, y'all?
Sure.
The GOAT.
All right, let's check this out and then we'll talk all about it.
My question is, how much money did they pay him?
Jordan
Michael
probably,
wasn't cheap.
He probably owns a stake in 2K at this point. Because
they still got to pay him.
Yeah, but I'm saying, like, they probably had to give up half the game. Revenue.
This is the matchup that everybody's been waiting to see.
Jordan, a drive.
Which, honestly, if we're being real, it's overdue. I feel like Michael Jordan should be on the board of directors for, like, the entire 2K franchise. Being what he did for basketball.
There's no gameplay. That sucks.
Yeah, just a cool little trailer.
Kind of a weak trailer.
Yeah, it really was. I'm surprised it's taking this long to get Jordan in the cover, but I'm surprised it's like 2K23 and not like 2K24, which would be the 25th 2K game.
See, this is why.
So the 25th anniversary, that would make sense to have Michael Jordan.
You have Webster Style on your marketing team.
Yeah, this is why the people need to be paying attention, because what a misstep. But, well, no, because it's the 24th game, right? Well, this is 2K23.
Yeah, Jordan's, so it's a 24 game because first one was 2K.
Yeah. Jordan's number is 23, right? I got a pair of shoes, right?
So that is right.
Yeah. I got a pair of shoes, right? Somewhere with the number.
Yeah. Okay. I wasn't thinking about that. Yeah. Having one in 2K23. Yeah. That makes sense.
Yeah.
When you look at it that way. But Jordan's like the biggest. I guess the only person you can get for the 25th one would be LeBron, maybe.
I guess.
Was Kobe on this year's?
I think Kobe was on. Yeah, he did have a variation.
Because I'm trying to think, like, just the greatest, and who would you want to have on the 25th anniversary? It's weird to even think that we're talking about next year will be 2K24, but it's literally the 25th game.
You're right. And
all the way that back franchise. To the Dreamcast. Goodness.
Y'all making so much money off of people who don't care about the fact that they playing the same game every year. It is very, very, very interesting. I'll leave it at that.
I feel that way about you. You know, back in the day, I think I bought, let me phrase that. When the series came out, I bought it every year because they're, and this is like every year from the Dreamcast to the Xbox. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're talking about 2K, 2K1, 2K22. Maybe 23 to me, 2K1, 2K2, 2K3, maybe 2K4, because there were definite improvements because the series is just starting.
Right.
So every year there were improvements graphically. You got new systems on Xbox, play, like there were things to be improved. Now, today, like I bought last 2K I bought was 2K19 because they were giving away for $3.99. That's the only reason I bought it.
Okay.
I play it sparingly. Do I have any reason to buy another 2K game? No, because it's basketball.
and this is the same conversation that I have with like my gamer friends who are like super in love with 2K. I'm like, it would make sense if the actual sport of basketball was undergoing changes.
Right.
But basketball has been basketball since basketball became basketball.
Right. So I feel the same way about Madden, about FIFA. Yeah. All those sports games that come out on a yearly basis. Realistically, these are games that should be a live service game.
Exactly. Yeah. They should be live service. They should be, it shouldn't be, oh, I have to buy a new disc every year or download a new game every year. It should just be like a DLC that comes out.
Exactly.
Go straight to, like, because what are you paying for? There's no changes happening.
Right. Exactly. Exactly. That's what I understand in today's age, because I'm not a game developer. Okay.
Right.
I never will be. I never have. I don't play one on TV. However, I'm pretty sure if you're making a game every single year, it's going to be very difficult to make substantial changes every single year. You may see changes 2-3 years down the line. Look at EA. EA, when the last time you put out an NBA Live game?
They can't. They don't have the all the rights over there with them.
Well, no. It's not exclusive to they don't have exclusive rights.
Oh, really?
2K doesn't have exclusive. They've never had exclusive rights to NBA.
Okay, never. So we need NBA Street to come back then.
Well, again, that's EA. EA got his own issues. We ain't going to that. Far as games and putting their foot in mouths and all that, especially this week. But my point is, well, EA, look at what they've done with Madden. Look what they've done with FIFA. And well, what is it going to be? EA Club Football, whatever now, since they're not using the FIFA license, whatever. Their track record for their yearly sports games, people buy it because literally they are the only option in town, especially when it comes to football.
Right.
And when it comes to, when it comes to American football, let me get that straight. They own the game time. When it comes to football right. or soccer, as we call it here in the United States, I don't know if they have the license as a whole, but they have the license to so many clubs that, because I know Konami's put out Pro 11. They had a soccer series that was very much a rival to FIFA. And that's a series I don't hear about anymore. I think it still exists, but with EA grabbing up all the licenses, I don't think it was much as far as like, if I'm a player, I want to play my favorite player.
Right.
There wasn't as much in Winning 11, I think it was called, compared to FIFA or EA Club Football. But even so, when you put out the same game every year, just a roster update, why do you expect me to pay, in this case, for next gen stuff, $69.99 and then $79.99. Right. Like, what, couldn't this have been like a $15 roster update? I don't think people would be upset with that. So with something like this,
unless you
were giving us something substantial of a change with 2K23 outside of Michael Jordan, what's the point?
Right. And to your point, like I said, I've had conversations with my gamer friends who are 2K players. They want that. They just want an update that's going to allow for the roster to be current from, you know, what's going on in the NBA today. And that's it. Like, they've made other strides in the game, like adding a rec area, and the My Player thing is really big now. Like, something with 2K23 that I just kind of like heard about that I'm gonna I'm gonna do some more deep diving into. I'm actually talking about it on the podcast this week. Okay. But apparently they're doing a you can do like virtual employment. So like there are Foot Lockers in the game and like Champ Sports and stuff like that. You can actually go on an interview, get hired to work in the game as a Foot Locker employee and earn real USD. I'm assuming that they just gonna give you some money so that you can go spend it on microtransactions in the 2K store. But I don't know. They're trying to do things to revolutionize the game and make it more entertaining and have a reason for a $69 price tag or $59, however much you're gonna charge. But at the end of the day, like I said,
let me be frank.
Basketball, and that's it. I do like the My Teams element, though, but just because I like the business behind basketball as well.
That's all great.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to work at Foot Locker in a video game if I want to play basketball.
But see, some people going to do it just so they don't have to spend their real hard-earned money on the Jordan shoes that are going to be in 2K23. Like they doing, I don't know, these 2K people are geniuses because they understand the actual NBA fan base. They understand that it's not going to take much to get them to come up off of their money. Like, it just is what it is at this point. They know that NBA fans are diehard. They love these players. They love these teams. They're going to support in whichever way they can, whether it's going to the game. They're still selling season passes. And there's a different person in the damn finals every year. Like,
it's 2K. I hear what you're saying. I just want a basketball game to be a basketball game.
To be a basketball game. And that's it.
And look, I will say this, though. Back in the day, when they introduced the My Crib stuff and everything, I bought credenzas and crap and for my trophy cases and all that on the Dreamcast era. I did that, but you know what? Mm-hmm. I didn't do it because there were no microtransactions, and it was like you got that stuff from playing the game and playing the basketball game, not about them selling you extra stuff and you having to buy credits and all this. Like, it was fun. It was like little extra stuff, not a whole economic model that now, hey, we want to nickel and dime you more after you already paid $70 for this game. And that's regular edition. We ain't talking about the Michael Jordan edition, which is probably damn near 100.
Yeah, the Michael Jordan, you're going to come off some real cash for that, And I already can see it now. It's going to be a box set with a tinfoil can, and you're going to get a code that's going to give you $10 off in the sneaker app for new Jordans. Like, I see it. Like, they're going to really brand out for this one. And I feel like for the 25th anniversary, it's not going to be just one player. It's going to be a bunch of greats on the cover, and that's how they're going to be like, oh yeah, get the dream team for 2025. It's gonna be Michael and Scotty, all kind of people, just
the 1992 sharing the cover team together.
Yeah, because they did that before, where it was like, I think it was whatever big three was really, really popular at the time. They had them on the cover for like a monumental time period in the game. I think it was like 2K20, like the 20th game that came out. Mm-hmm. I think it was like LeBron and Wade, and I don't know which big three they had on there, but I know they shared a cover at some point.
Got you.
But, all right, there we go. Get them pockets ready, essentially. NBA basically 23.
Right. Michael Jordan, if you're a 2K player and you're watching this reaction right now, you already know you're about to spend some money. So, like, everything we saying, we just either pissing you off or making you excited for the game.
And Brian is absolutely right.
Like, it just is what it is.
All right. There you go. So where you can send your hate mail, Brian Saf?
Well, you can send that back to yourself. But if you want to have a conversation about why 2K is stealing all of your money, and ways that you can communicate with EA in order to get them to give you better product for your money, this is where you want to go. Now, I don't tolerate disrespect and rudeness and stuff. I haven't had to block anybody yet, but I know how to do it. So be kind with your words. We can have a friendly conversation. I'm not like a big 2K player, so you can school me all you want to. At the end of the day, if you don't have a pair of Jordans for me, you're wasting your time.
But I let them know.
Let's talk. I'm fine with that.
There we go, Brian. Webster style, how about you?
I'm telling you this way. Brian, I feel you. You come in with that smoke. I've been playing 2K since 1999, so you can come at me with that smoke. I know what I'm talking about.
Real 2K player.
Right, exactly.
There since the inception.
Exactly. So I know when it was actually just about basketball and love of basketball, not microtransactions. So don't come at me, Brian.
See,
but if you want to, you can find me on Instagram and Twitter at Webster Style. You can also find me on TikTok at underscore Webster Style. And of course, anything and everything that is Webster Style, you can find it at WebsterStyle.com.
And I also want to say before we close, that Rec Room Street thing that they added on like the last, what, maybe 2 years ago to the NBA, that is not the same thing as NBA Street.
I agree. It's not
like NBA Street is complete. I know they do it now. I know they got 3v3. You can play outside on court. It's not the same thing. I just want to watch some gameplay footage. YouTube is great. You're here right now crying about the fact that we're shitting on your game. Go watch some gameplay.
We didn't say it was a bad game. We just said it's microtransaction heavy.
Right. And see, nickel and diamond heavy. 2K. It's not a bad game.
No,
the thing with it is, it's not a changing game. Like, if you're if it's gonna be the same game, I don't need to spend $70 every year for it. Like,
exactly.
Give me the roster update. If you want me to add a DLC that does something else to the game, sure, $20, fine. But you acting like it's a brand new game. Like, LeBron is still in the league. Like, there's nobody replacing him. You got Jordan running around doing dunks on the cover and shit like that. Jordan don't play no more. He don't even own a team in the NBA no more. Like,
yes, he do. Wow. Bobcats.
Oh, he does still own the Bobcats. See, look at this. This is why you need to not talk to us, because we know things that you probably should not.
I
it
did.
Is what it is.
Yeah, I'm too old to deal with any smoke, man. I just don't care. So if you got a problem, y'all know where to go. It's this Allegedly Kuya P on Twitter, TikTok, and IG. Of course, Show Pass Show, AAPI Toy Heroes, and here with Brian Saff, Webster Style, at the NRW, at New Release Wednesday, where nerds rule the world. There you go, y'all. NBA 2K23.
Shout out to Jordan, though, because money and black.
Oh, my God.